Hello everyone, welcome to your 9-3 lesson on ellipses. Our learning target for today, we're going to be able to describe the features of an ellipse given its equation or graph. We'll be able to derive the equation from an ellipse. We will write and graph the equation of an ellipse and use an ellipse to model a real-world situation. We'll be able to graph a transformed ellipse by completing the square to rewrite the equation in an equivalent form. Actually, we might not be doing that one. Let's see where this takes us. All right, so as you can see, we have a lot of vocab to fill in, so I want to get started with this right away. First is our definition for ellipse. All right, our definition of an ellipse. The set of points P in a plane such that the sum of the distances from any point P to two fixed points, F1 and F2, is a constant. So you can see our picture of an ellipse. Here's F1 and F2. Those are fixed points. Any point in the plane where the sum of the distances to F1 and F2 is constant creates an elliptical shape like this. So what we're saying is that we've got point P. This distance plus this distance equals a number. Every single point, so let's say we have a point over here. Let's say this is where point P is. The distance to F2 plus the distance to F1 is the same as this point P, the distance to those fixed points. That's what this down here is saying. The distance from P to F1 plus the distance from P to F2 is equal to a constant K. The foci of an ellipse, those are those fixed points. The F1 and the F2 numbers that we referenced above. So we're going to add in also, put stars by this, the distance from the focus, that's a singular, foci is plural, from the focus to the center of the ellipse is equal to our C value. So when we start looking at the equations of ellipses, our C value is that distance from the focus to the center. All right, next we have the major axis. That's going to be the segment that passes through the foci with endpoints on the ellipse. So here's your foci. We can see from here to here with endpoints on the ellipse, this is what we call the major axis. All right, so vertices. Those are going to be the endpoints of the major axis. Vertices, or each vertex, will be on the ellipse. Those are the endpoints of the major axis that passes through the foci. We are going to have another little important thing we have to write in. The distance from the vertex to the center, that is our A value. Again, C value, A value, you're going to see that in some upcoming videos, but now you'll have it referenced with stars next to it in your notes. All right, next we have the minor axis. This is the segment that is perpendicular to the major axis at the center, that's where they intersect, with endpoints on the ellipse. So if we look at our picture, here's our major axis right here. Here's our minor axis. You can see the endpoints are on the ellipse as well. So covertices we saw in the picture up there, those are the endpoints of the minor axis. And we're going to add in, and I'm, whoop, not with that. We're going to add in, here we go. The distance from the covertex to the center is going to be our B value. All right, the center of the ellipse, that is going to be the midpoint of the major and the minor axis. So it will be where they cross. And it is the midpoint of each axis. So if we take a look at our picture, if this center right here is the midpoint, that means from the covertex to the center, covertex to the center, those are going to be the same measurement. Those are going to be the B value that we talked about. So B value is the distance from the covertex to the center. Your major axis, those are the same distance to the center. That is what your A value is going to be. And then the focus, either focus, the distance from the focus to the center, that is your C value. And that would be the same on either side. All right, so one last note we want to write in. How do the A, B, and C values relate in an ellipse? So this is going to be another starred thing you're going to need to know. A squared is going to be equal to B squared plus C squared. All right, let's take a look at some examples.